Dofcia TV here. Today we'll be recapping Hollow Man, a 2000 science fiction horror film, directed by Paul Verhoeven. In this film, Dr. Sebastian Kane, actor Kevin Bacon, replaces Dr. Jack Griffin, actor Claude Rains, in H.G. Wells' The Invisible Man, which is partially based on that novel. An invisibility serum for the U.S. military is being developed by a talented, but slightly megalomaniacal, molecular researcher, who is also working on a serum that will bring the subject back to visible. Since he's been working on it for the past 4 years, Sebastian has been using animals housed in a top-secret military lab that only he and his team have access to. On Isabel, a female gorilla, he is currently working to reverse the invisibility effect. They found that phase-shifting a living thing into invisibility was simple, but phasing them back to visible proved tough. Isabel's visibility can be restored with this molecular model reconfiguration that he worked on for a long time late at night and instantly reported his success to his superiors. A scientist on Sebastian's team is enamored with his ex-girlfriend Dr. Linda McKay, Elizabeth Shue, despite the fact that she is busy working on the serum. Dr. Matt Kensington, Josh Brolin, another member of their study team, has a crush on her, but he has no idea. By working with vet Sarah Kennedy and Carter Abbey, as well as technicians Frank Chase and Janice Walton, together with veterinarians Joey Slotnick and Mary Randall, Sebastian and his team are able to get the serum to work on the gorilla. Sebastian toasts the finest research group in the world at a sumptuous dinner in celebration. Reversion, on the other hand, appears to have been the last great step forward for Sebastian. To the oversight committee, including his former teacher Dr. Howard Kramer, William Devane, Sebastian strangely lies about his success and convinces Linda and Matt to lie to the other four team members, saying that Kramer and the board have approved human testing. The focus is on Sebastian as a person. Despite the difficult transition to openness, the procedure succeeds. Sebastian wakes up in pain and recoils from the ambient light, recognizing that he can see through his eyelids after being comatose for 17 hours due to shock. Clinical tests are then carried out on him. After 3 days, the reversion fails and almost kills him when he returns to the public eye. I'm sure you're enjoying this story, so a simple like and subscription would be greatly appreciated. If you haven't already. Sebastian is given a latex mask to wear around the lab that attempts to resemble a human. A new method of making Sebastian visible is discovered by Matt during this period. In contrast, a computer simulation fails. Sebastian's patience begins to fray after a few days of being cooped up in the lab like a prisoner. He breaks Carter's and his own rules by sneaking out of the lab and going to his apartment to get some books, CDs, and Twinkies. He first spies on his neighbor, Rona Mitra, and then rapes her, completely undetected, in the middle of the night. Sebastian is not to be found in Linda's apartment when she arrives. As the others were preparing to pursue Sebastian, he returned to the lab. In the event that he leaves again, Linda and Matt will inform Dr. Kramer of their actions. Overcoming this threat, Sebastian builds an apparatus that plays back an endless loop of his heat signature in the lab, making Frank believe Sebastian is still there when, in fact, he has snuck out to spy on Linda and Matt. Sebastian breaks the window out of Linda's bedroom as he finds Matt and Linda preparing to have sex. Frank tells them that Sebastian is still in bed, so the two call him. A furious Sebastian returns to the lab after seeing Linda and Matt together and is enraged by the concept. As the dog's barking became unbearable, Sebastian approached it, reassured it that he meant no harm, and then savagely smashed it against the cage wall with his own hands until it died. The team soon discovers that they had been watching a tape and that Sebastian had left without their knowledge. Dr. Kramer's residence is visited by Linda and Matt, who inform them of the experiment on Sebastian. Disappointed, Dr. Kramer informs them that the project is over. Despite Dr. Kramer's best efforts, Sebastian has followed Linda and Matt into the house. Kramer is tricked out of the house by Sebastian, who subsequently drowns him in his own pool. A simple like and subscription would be greatly appreciated. If you haven't already. He returns to the lab the following day and disables all phones and elevator codes save for his own after waiting for everyone to arrive. As soon as he removes his latex mask and clothing, he sets out to find them. While the crew is looking for Sebastian, Janice is strangled with an forline and her body is stuffed into a locker. While Linda, Sarah, and Frank hide in the lab after discovering Janet's corpse, Matt and Carter use tranquilizer pistols to search for Sebastian in the abandoned hallways equipped with thermographic imaging goggles. They eventually locate Sebastian. Matt points his gun at a steam vent's heat signature. Carter is thrown into the air by Sebastian, who is perched on top of a pipe. Sebastian tosses Carter onto a steel rod, which slashes his carotid artery, resulting in severe blood loss. Linda rescues Matt from Sebastian's clutches. Carter, who is barely conscious and severely injured, is discovered by Sarah and Frank. Despite Frank's desires, Sarah sets out on her own to obtain blood for a transfusion. She waits for Sebastian to tread on the blood she's splattered all over the room, hoping he'll betray where she's hiding. Sebastian, on the other hand, attacks her and shoots her with a tranquilizer dart before breaking her neck. Frank is tending to Carter, who is rapidly deteriorating in Frank's care when Linda and Matt arrive. Carter has bled to death, and the three of them set out to find Sarah, who is still alive. In the walk-in freezer, they find her dead. Frank attempts to expose Sebastian by using a fire extinguisher, but Sebastian surprises him and kills him with a crowbar. He then uses the hook end of the blade to stab Matt in the lower chest. In order to kill Linda and Matt, Sebastian locks them in a freezer, cranks the temperature control all the way down, and then leaves them to freeze to death. Sebastian spends a long time putting on his latex mask and outfit, making sure he seems as human as possible. Linda uses duct tape to bandage Matt's wound and then devises a way out of the freezer. Linda utilizes a defibrillator and other lab equipment to build an electromagnet, which she uses to open the door. As she warms Matt up, she assembles the components of a flamethrower. With nitroglycerin, Sebastian is destroying and burying evidence of his team members' deaths. His plan is to use nitrous oxide in a centrifuge, set the timer, and then destroy the keyboard. At just the right moment, Linda appears and fires her crude blowtorch at him. Sebastian's latex mask and clothes are charred beyond recognition as the flames engulf him. In order to partially uncover him, Linda uses a flamethrower to activate the sprinklers in the ceiling. Just as Sebastian is about to lose, Matt appears and slams the crowbar into him. Sebastian regains consciousness and grabs the crowbar. However, he swings the crowbar while wet and electrocutes himself. Electricity coursing through Sebastian's body partially reveals his muscles and bones, but not his skin or the hair that is left on him. I'd appreciate it if you could just like and subscribe, if you haven't already done so. To save themselves, Linda and Matt decide to leave the lab by climbing up the elevator shaft. The laboratory goes up in flames as a result of an explosion. Sebastian interrupts the two as they are about to leave the house. A final kiss for old time's sake precedes Linda killing Sebastian with an elevator cable grab and car knockout, sending Sebastian tumbling into the blazing inferno below. Medical personnel take Linda and Matt away in an ambulance after they exit from the engulfed laboratory. The end. Now let's explain this movie, Hollow Man. Hollow Man movie explained. It's time for Hollow Man to join Jack Frost in the Underachievement Hall of Fame. When the father of a deceased child returns as a snowman, all he can think to do is counsel his son about a bully at school. You'll remember that movie. You receive an invisible scientist who can only be turned into an insane killer by the power of invisibility. Director Paul Verhoeven appears to have such a low opinion of his audience in Hollow Man that he thinks the only thing we care about is whether or not we get to see the invisible man go crazy. The Fly, David Cronenberg's 1986 film about a scientist who tries his theories on himself and becomes imprisoned in the nature of the creature he becomes, is a better comparison for this picture. It was a film that sparked my interest. As a stunt, Hollow Man transforms the scientist into a sex fiend, goes insane, and assaults everyone. Is today's audience so engrossed with violence that they no longer care about anything else? It's Kevin Bacon, who played a bunch of medical students in Flatliners, 1990, who dared to explore just how close they could go to death before they perished and returned to tell the tale. This was a film that piqued my interest. Dr. Sebastian Cain, a scientist who has perfected an invisibility solution, tests it on animals and then injects it into himself, is now his latest role in the film industry. Then, Hollow Man has no other choice except to spy on and assault his girlfriend and his neighbor. Please like and subscribe if you have the time. That's if you haven't done so previously. It's a pity. A real shame, because the film's spectacular effects are some of the most fascinating I've ever seen. We witness a chemical being pumped into the gorilla's circulation early in the film, and we see it racing up an artery to the heart and then spreading out into the circulatory system as the gorilla stays completely invisible. Basically, it's a chart of the veins' routes. In the following scenes, we observe both gorilla and scientist gradually lose visibility and then gradually regain it. The intermediate stages are like those see-through pages in high school biology textbooks, exactly like them, even to the see-through genitals. I'm in awe of these results. Making visible what is invisible is also a source of amusement in this film. When the sprinkler system is activated and the firefighting chemicals are sprayed on him, blood is splattered all around. After that, it's basically a slasher movie with an interesting science premise. I'm curious as to why the Pentagon would invest so much money in a top-secret underground facility in order to develop this method. Motion and heat detectors are clearly able to identify the presence of the invisible man. Any kind of security system would have difficulty keeping him safe. Isn't it more cost-effective to employ spies or electronic bugging devices? This film isn't a good location for logical arguments, to begin with. An elevator shaft is filled with flames and an explosive fireball. A jet stream of superheated hot gas should theoretically be pushed over the apparent flames, incinerating the heroine. However, this movie does not. Dr. Linda McKay, played by Elizabeth Shue, who got an Oscar nomination for Leaving Las Vegas, is the film's protagonist. There isn't a whole lot to like here, but she and Kevin Bacon do their best. Josh Brolin's Matthew Kensington and Dr. Kane's former lover, Dr. Kane, are both jealous of each other in the film's script. He goes into a rage if Bacon sees them together since the invisibility process makes him more animalistic. A 25-minute action sequence in which the monster chases the scientist around the lab like someone who has spent a lot of time studying the thing will suffice as an excuse. I believe the film works on a mechanical level. However, it offers nothing but the most basic things to the party. RoboCop, Total Recall, and Basic Instinct were all directed by Paul Verhoeven, who is known for his wit and creativity. Hollow Man is a sequel to Starship Troopers, in which humans travel to the stars to squash bugs. There is a man in need of a dose of hope. Check the description to watch this movie on demand platforms. Thank you for your participation in this community. I hope we were still able to deliver with this story. Let us know what you think of this story. And if you aren't already a part of this family, please subscribe to this channel and turn on the notification bell to receive videos as soon as they are released and to be eligible to win a variety of prizes from us. Check out the movie that is currently on your screen. It's also a fantastic one. Dopsia Television. Do it, click it. Do it. I'm looking forward to seeing you. Check out the story that's currently on your screen. It's also a good one. If you aren't already a member of the family, you can subscribe to this channel for more fantastic stories like these. Hey! Thank you for your ongoing support. It is greatly appreciated. We'll see you in the next one. Dopsia TV.